Now, Jira is a like big structure. So we have divided into various parts. Like in this session, we will be learning some 20-30%, in next another 20-30%. Then we can learn the whole Jira. You can get your time to do a practice. You can come up with your query, and then we can start with another chapters. So in today's chapter, in basic, we are going to start with boards, board columns, components, filters, labels. Now, this is one configuration. And this configuration will float this many number of things, like epic, story, task, subtask, sprint, and time log. Right? So let's have a short introduction about each and every point. Like, now what is epic? Everyone is now confused what I need to create. Epic, story, task, how to create. So now what is epic? So let's say some people say now WhatsApp is coming with an epic solution, epic feature. Now WhatsApp has allowed for 8 people to join in a call conference. Now WhatsApp has a status as a functionality. Let's go on a ride to Leh Ladakh. It would be a epic in the life. So kuch hota hai na ke ye ek bahut bada main kuch kaam kar jaun. So that is simple terminology, kind of epic. Ki mujhe kuch itna mujhe achieve karna hai, ek fantastic cheez mujhe achieve karni hai. Right? So here we can consider epic as a new version, as a new phase of the project, as a new module. Right, epic could be anything which is going to impact your application. Now let's say login and registration. Now you are adding the feature login with biometric, so that is not an epic, that is add-on enhancement, right? But let's say in e-commerce there is a B2B and B2C project on iOS, Android and web. Now you are going to add a loyalty program. So that is called epic, because epic will break all other modules. It will affect all other modules, right? Now, epic will have a stories. Epic can also have a sub epics as well. Story can also have a sub stories as well. Stories will have a task. Task will have a subtask. This is a bunch of activity. This goes into one sprint, right? एक नहीं कहते, एक रनर ने कुछ 5 स्प्रिंट कंप्लीट किया, बट एक स्प्रिंट क्या होता है? एक स्प्रिंट उसके लिए 100 मीटर का भी रन हो सकता है, 200 मीटर का भी रन हो सकता है, 400 मीटर का भी रन हो सकता है, राइट? तो स्प्रिंट कुड बी एनी साइज एंड इट विल हैव अ एपिक स्टोरी, टास्क एंड सब टास्क. सो लेट्स से एग्जांपल, अभी एक एग्जांपल ले सकते हैं कि एपिक एक हमारा एक मॉड्यूल है. जैसे कंसीडर कर ले हम लोग के यूजर मॉड्यूल. स्टोरी है हमारा लॉगिन, अनदर रजिस्ट्रेशन, अनदर फॉरगॉट पासवर्ड, अनदर चेंज पासवर्ड, माय प्रोफाइल एंड एडिट प्रोफाइल. नाउ लॉगिन विल हैव अ डिफरेंट टास्क, नॉर्मल लॉगिन, लॉगिन विद बायोमेट्रिक. नाउ अगेन लॉगिन विल हैव अ डिफरेंट सब टास्क, यूआई एक्टिविटी, API activity, functional activity, validation activity, right? So this will float like this way. Okay. So today we don't have any presentation. We don't have any PPT. We are going to roll out everything practical here from just top to bottom. So first of all, I will cover up this much area. Then Shweta will continue from epic.
Okay. Okay. Just a moment. We have a Rizwan sir from Magento team in today's session, and Rizwan sir is a certified Scrum master. So Rizwan sir, can you share your insights as well about the difference between epic, story, task and all things?
I think Hasesko, I think all the things about that as well, but I think if sometime needed I will give my input on them, so for sure.
Please keep providing your inputs wherever you think that.
Yeah, sure. Okay. There will be about sprint and and about Kanban board as well, but I will give my input at that time. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Okay.
Please put me on a hold if somewhere I'm going in a wrong direction.
You're going in a good direction, Asya. Keep it up.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Sure.
Thank you.
Okay. So, whenever there is a project and project manager like create a project in Jira, right, then we'll have this kind of access. Let's say this is one of my Jira access. Now this is one of my project grow app. So this is, I have just taken as an example here because I need to create a board and etc. So let me go to the project. Now when you go to the project, this is your actually a content area, your working area, but your main menu is here, right? So in whichever the board you were last logged in, that will come up here. So these are all the boards, right? Some of our current projects boards, some of our exercise board. So now I'm going to, first of all, what we need to do, we need to create a board. So there are two types of board, right? So I'm going to create a board. So now there are two options. One is Scrum board and another is a Kanban board. So now how the boards will help. So in board, Scrum board will help us in a development time. And Kanban board will help us in a QA process. Yes, we can also use Kanban in a development as well, but Scrum is better. I will show you in the example, right? So first of all, let's say I'm going to create a Scrum board. So whenever you have existing boards, it will ask you for the filters from any existing. You can select, that is okay. So now I'm going to create Grow App Development Board, which is by Scrum. So here you can see this is my board, right? Now in this board, whenever I go to this board, I have a backlog. Now in backlog, all the previous tickets, the stories, the tasks, the issues, everything is here because the component is not yet applied. That's why it is coming here, right? Okay. Now you do remember this thing. Grow App Development has a backlog here. Now let me create a one more board, which is a Kanban board. As I said, like Kanban will help in a QA process. So now I'm going to create a Kanban board from existing project. Let's say QA board. Now you see there is no backlog. Right, so whatever activity is there, that will actually come to the to-do. Now, let us go to the Scrum board. Now here we have a backlog. So backlog is kind of your bucket. Now whatever the story, epic, task, subtask you create, that will be in the backlog. It will be in your bucket. Now whenever you want to configure any subtask to task, task to stories, stories to epic, and that whole bunch goes to the sprint. And you can decide like this sprint will start from like 25th May to 1st of June for a 1 week, 40 hours. Then you can start, then it will go from backlog to active sprints. Right? So here we will get a facility of backlog in a Scrum board, but you will not get a facility in a Kanban board. So for the development, because what happens, TL and PL, they will keep writing a number of things, user module, then all the stories, all the tasks, subtasks, product module, all the stories, tasks, subtasks. So it will be in a backlog and they can configure sprint at different levels, right? So these are the two different types of board. Now, when I go to any board, like everything is previously visible. So let's start with the development board. So here in sprint, there is a nothing. In backlog, there are many more things. Some of the things from website as well, some of from iOS as well, some from Android as well. So now I need to go here for a board setting. And there will be a columns and edit filters. So let's discuss about board columns first of all. So board's columns are, let's say I'm going to this Kanban board. This board has a to do, in progress, done, right? Same way, when I go to the development in active sprint, there are three columns. Common structure that we will share across with you. Like we will be doing many columns in the development. To do, in progress, development testing, which is unit testing, ready for QA, and done. Right? So now I'm going to configure my development board, which is a Scrum board. So in the board settings, there are columns. So you see to do, in progress, done. Now I need to create, to do is there, in progress is there, done is there. So unit testing or a development testing and ready for QA I need to create. So how to create a columns, right? So here is a add column. Development testing, and there are only two types of category. So we have to select it in progress only, because whenever you put in the done, it will not come back, and the to do will have the list of the things from active sprint. So we will select in progress only for this two columns, right? So this column is done. You can do your configuration from here, just drag and drop, right? Ready for QA. Let's say ready for QA. So that is here, right? So now I'm going to my board again. Active sprint. So these columns are available. Okay. Now I have a backlog, and backlog has a iOS, Android, web, everything. So now I need to configure the next thing, which is component, filter, and labels. So I'm going to board setting. Let's take an example. This grow up development is for my iOS only. So now I will be doing a edit filter query. And here I need to select a type. Now this development board will have a epic, story, task, and subtask. This is going to be a bunch as a sprint, and there we can do a time log. So this development board will not have a bug, right? So this one you need to configure, and The another, in more, here we have a component. So let's say Android, iOS, API and web. Now this board might be only for the iOS. You need to select iOS. Right. I can save the filters. Whenever I will go to the backlog. Now see, there is nothing. Everything is filtered because the filters are been applied. In active sprint, there is nothing. Right now, whatever the epic story, subtask, and task we will create, that will come in the backlog. And from backlog, we can create a one sprint. So this is basic configuration for board. One thing is pending here, which we will be seeing labels in this this time, epic story, task creation, and the bug board time, because there it is only beneficial. So this is for the Scrum board, which we will be using for the development. And these are the minimum configuration, right? Now I have created another Kanban board, which is for the QA. Now whenever you go to this Kanban board, again it has a number of columns, so we need to configure columns again, board columns same way. To do in progress and done, we need to apply one fixed, which is ready for QA, right? So add column. Now ready for QA, I cannot take it here. Why it is not happening? Because in the previous board, I have created that column. That's why it is not allowing me to create a same column here. So I am marking ready for QC. Ready for QC is already taken. So let's say for QA to test. So here the column is, now again same way, in general query filter, again this is only related to, now here in the types we need to select a bug only, so all the bugs are here. Let's say this is only for the iOS, so I will be selecting iOS and save. So now yes, this Kanban board is also ready. Yet there is no backlog, there is no bucket, right? To do, in progress, ready for test, and done is there. Now you may be confused for the different columns usage. So first, in the development, which comes from sprint to to-do, right? So whatever the sprint I have created, sprint will have a epic story, task, and task. It will come to the to-do list. Now whenever the developers start working on it, they will drag and drop to in progress. Whenever they are doing a unit testing or a project lead is going to observe, they will be putting this into the development. If there is any review level issue or any point is there, they will again drag and drop to do with proper notes and comments. and labels and filters. If it is done and I need to provide it for the QA, then I will drag and drop for the QA. If QA is approved, then I can keep it in the done and which is ready for the client. Now I can take this task, take this screen, take this module for the client release, right? So these are the five columns. And in development, whatever the bug which is created by QA, it will directly go to to-do by default because of Kanban board. There is no bucket, there is no backlog. Whenever any developer working on it, it will go to the in progress. If this issue has been fixed, verified, and they need to provide it to the QA with status, with the URL, with the build, then they will drag and drop to fixed, which is ready for QA, for QA test, etc. And once QA is satisfied, they will drag and drop to the done. Right? If this is not been configured or done or resolved properly, then QA again can put a comment and they can drag and drop to the to-do. Or they can keep it over there and they can have an internal communication like this issue has a this many, this issue has a 5 points. Now out of 5 points, 4 points are resolved, one is pending. So developer and lead need to take care for this. Right? So this is overall about like types of board, board columns, components, and a filters. Labels are a different part which we'll be covering here, because possibly what is label now? Let me give you the introduction. Labels are now, I have a two developers working in iOS. Let's say example, Shweta and Sagar. So whatever the issue, the story, the task, the subtask, I need to assign, then I can mark it in the label. Right? Let's say this is one of the issue, right? The developer name. Then whenever they apply a filter, it will be available. Component, again, which is iOS, Android, web, API, backend, admin panel, right? So there are two types of board. Scrum is for development and Kanban is for a QA process. Okay. Any query in this much area, or we can continue with configuring Epic story?
Chaitanya sir, like do you have any queries like how you how you can update things into Udo, how you can take it out this time? These in Udo?
No, as of now, no any query, but I will know surely if I have. Okay.
Siddharth here.
Yes, Siddharth.
So whatever filters you are creating, so will it be applicable to all users who are assigned to project, or is it limited to you, all your access to your backlog?
No, filters are for all the users.
Okay.
Right. This project is created by Amit sir in the Jira.
Okay.
And the access for the developer, which is given to me and Nilay, right? So now Amit sir has a different access. Now I have created a board, right? Then I cannot delete a board. Only Amit sir can delete a board, because at the time of the we need to check the performance of the project at the time of the completion of the project. Then yes, PL and PL might not have all the access. Only PM will have the access. So if I continuously create unnecessary boards, not managing proper tasks, then it will affect. So yes, filter, components, labels, that is okay. We all can use it, utilize. But only one difference is there between developer access and PM access, which we cannot delete the board. That is only a difference. If PM will allow you, then they can go to their setting, they can go to their panel and they can allow you. Similar, like we have a user module on admin panel, like super admin will have this much access, admin will have this much access, data entry operator will have this much access, similar kind of. But yes, filter components, this columns, creating a board, this many area, there is no difference, nothing.
Yeah, I asked questions because in a one backlog there can be iOS and web together to user. So if someone applied a filter of iOS, then web user will not be able to see that web task or something. Correct?
Correct. So what happens in that case, let's say in this grow app project, so I'm working on a mobile part, I'm working on iOS and Android, and Nilay and team is working on a WordPress part. So this is the board I have created for the example right now. So now you see, I have created GA mobile, which is my development board. There is my backlog. I keep writing up stories over there, task and subtask over there for the development team. And QA is applying this GA mobile bug board, which is for iOS and Android. Right now, Nilay and team, which is from WordPress, they are working on this project. So there is another board, GA web, and there is a bug board, GA web bug board. So that way we can filter. Now let's assume there is an issue in mobile bug board, right? So now, you see, I can show you in this board. I have a components like iOS and Android. Right?
Right.
Now, when Nilay will go his board, his team will go to the bug board for the web. Now, they have a component as an API and web. So let's assume I receive any bug in mobile team, like forgot password is not working. And when I drill down to the code and I found like this is API issue, right? Let's say example, this one. Now here the component is there and the label is there, right? So right now I'm not going to update it, but I will just show you. I can fetch the API developer, let's say Chetan. And in component, I will mark it as a API. Okay. So now this issue is also available to Chetan, who is working on a web and the board, which has a component as an API. So they can see in their to-do list.
Okay.
Correct?
Correct.
So this way we can assign an issue. Similar like Mantis, we are assigning an issue to different developers. Right?
Right.
And when this two developers can cross verify, like this is done, we can remove the Android developer from here and the component of Android. Then it would be permanent to the API issue. The labels could be anything. Like let's say if this is the suggestion, this is not an issue. You can mark suggestion. If you need to give a KT to QA or a project lead any, you can mark a knowledge share. You can mark any. So by the filter, the labels that can help you, what are the number of KT you need to discuss? What are the number of suggestions you need to discuss? Okay?
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Any other query for this many points? Or we can continue with Epic and another things? Okay. Now, now what could be the Epic? Now, I told some example about Epic. Now what could be the Epic? Can someone say like what could be the Epic? And let us try to configure their situation here in Epic Story, Task and Subtask, anyone from any project who can come up and say, like, this could be my Epic. This is my new thing I need to do. Anyone from mobile team, web team, BA team, anybody? Okay.
Hello. Hello.
Yes.
Hello, sir. I'm Monali. Now I want to I want to tell you about Epic. Right, in Yugo application, we have now recharge module, so it can be in Epic, right?
Right. Correct. So now we'll be starting a work on a recharge module.
Yes.
Right. So now recharge will have an impact on a user module and another things. Because for the recharge, the mobile number, the user authentication, that comes from the user module. If I log in with my email ID and password, then I get authenticate to the application. That authentication goes to the recharge module. So like, yes, we are going to configure Yugo for a flight booking, hotel booking, recharge module. Another thing. So this all are the epics.
Okay.
So this could be the epic as well. Okay. Permal.
Hello.
Permal, we are doing one R&D on a Huawei App Store for Eagle Hills.
Okay.
This could be a epic or not.
It could be an epic.
Okay, and how? Like, let's say this could be an epic, then can you just give me a short example, like how it could be an epic? What could be a story, task and subtask?
The story would be like R&D on Huawei application. And subtask it, what exactly we are going to do, like dividing a story into different, like we have a different module, right? What exactly we are going to follow, so that can be a subtask.
Okay, correct. So let's example for the epic story, task and subtask. Now let's say one of our project, it has a support for iOS and Android. Now Huawei is a Chinese company. Now Google Play Store is not applied to the Huawei and they have their own OS. Now client is asking to submit an APK, our Android project, on a Huawei App Store as well. We need to give a one more App Store support. So that could be my Epic, Huawei App Store support. Now the whole project is done on a native Android with Kotlin or a Java. Now there are a different functionalities like Google Map, Firebase push notification, etc. So let's assume there would be two stories. So now similar like Google is not accepting Huawei, Huawei is also not accepting Google. Now if I will be putting the application Huawei, Huawei developers, they will reject my application because of Google Map and Firebase push notification. They have their own push notification architecture. They have their own maps. Right, Permal?
Yes.
So let's assume like story would be story one, removing support of Google components like map and Firebase, whatever it is there, right? And another story
Hasish sir, you need to like faster a bit, we are running out of the time.
Yes sir. Applying support for Huawei components. So this could be the two stories. Now this stories will have a task like this one. Need to remove Google Map, need to remove Firebase push notification, find out if any other dependency for the Google. Now this could be the another task, the bunch. Apply Huawei Maps, apply Huawei push notification, App Store details, screenshots, upload application, get the approval from the Huawei developers and release the app. So this way, and this would be the whole bunch. This would be the epic, right? Now what happens if Google Map has another dependency? So that goes to the task into subtask. Now this would be the one sprint. I will configure this everything into my backlog, configure one sprint and give it to Perumal. So clear about this idea for the epic story, task, subtask and sprint. Yes, the time log is there. Now for the whatever the task and subtask is there, I can give a estimation time. Like this task could take 8 hours, 4 hours, 16 hours, etc. So whenever they will complete a task and put it in a done column and close the sprint, that moment they need to provide a time. We will get to know for that that thing at the time of the closing of sprint. Now we are going to do a practical for this epic story, task and subtask. Any theoretical query here, or we can start a practical? Okay, I guess Shweta, you can go ahead with the epic story, task, subtask.
Hello everyone, good morning. So as Shweta, said by Harsha sir,
Shweta, there are two boards which I created, you can apply in that. So after this session I can ask Amit sir to remove the boards, right? You need to share your screen. So first of all, share your screen, then you can continue. I'm putting off my screen share. Yes, Shweta, you can go ahead.
Okay. Asha sir, is my screen available?
Not yet.
I need access something.
You don't need any kind of access. Hasse sir, can you stop sharing?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Shweta, can you please try now?
Yes. It does not support, I think. I don't know.
You have to click or share screen in the bottom.
Yes, menu. but it's giving error from a browser.
Okay, fine. No worries. Harsha sir, can you share your screen back and Shweta can guide what other things need to be done?
Yes.
Yes, sure. I can do. Otherwise, I can take.
No,
pick
like
up a reading epic and etc.
No, no, let's Shweta guide you what to do and etc. You just share your screen and she will.
Okay, done.
Okay, so first of all, I will show how to create a epic stories and its subtasks, which is required from our development side. So first of all, Harsha sir, in that Grow App Developer. Yes, you can see here a left side panel, versions and epics. Okay, so if you want to create an epic, then click on that epic and create epic. Yes. Okay, so enter your epic name, like said by Harsha sir, Huawei support, app support, or whatever it is your epic name that you can enter. Right, then you can enter your summary also what is epic requirements and all the summary you can write over here. And here are the configure fields on the right side. There is, you have to select a component. Okay, so this is for iOS. So we can select here iOS.
If you remember when I created this board, I have applied the components, the iOS, because this board is for the iOS. So if I don't select a component here for creating this story, let's say I'm going to remove this component, right? I'm not going to add any component and I'm going to create this epic, right? So epic GA73, right? That epic is been created, but you see, I cannot see anywhere. That is not in a backlog. That is not in an epic. That is also not in a version. Why this happened? Because this board is configured with iOS component only. Now this is general issue happens with everyone. So this is my epic, which is GA73. Now I need to go here and I need to apply the component.
Yes, sure. This is the important thing that we all need to take care of.
Where is that?
Once you add component from there, then it will reflect on that epic panel.
Right. So I have applied the component. Now I am here on a backlog and just going to reload my page. So now in Epic, this is available. Yes. Earlier, it was not available because of component. So if you don't select your component matching with your board, it will not be available anywhere.
Yes. Please move to that Epic.
Okay.
Yes. Select that arrow. Left side. So that which you can apply for differentiate your epics, and you can change your name, you can see its details, and if everything is done from here, then you can mark as done also. These are the options available. Click on this left side arrow. Huawei app supports left side. Yes, expand. Okay, so here, if you want to create any story in this epic, then you have to click on this create issue in epic. Please do on that create issue in epic. Yes, from this you can create a story in this epic. Which story? Yes, story. And enter your story's name, which is the applying support of, okay, removing support of Google components. Yes, and you can add components also here. Or if you have any TTL, something like that, and you can also add in this attachment also. You can write a description over here. Yes, then create.
Okay.
It will create a story in this epic.
Correct. Now, at the time of the creating this story, it will create a story, but how to bind this story with this particular epic?
It will now, automatically bind.
Okay. From here as well, you can select your epic. It will also bind to this.
Yes, create.
So now this is one of the stories there.
Yes. And that is linked to Huawei app support, app store support, which you can see here in backlog. Okay. Now go to that story.
Okay.
Okay. Left in the right side, there are open in new tab. So we can get that its components.
Okay.
Okay. So you can see here, this story is created for the Huawei App Store support, right? And in the right side, you can see it's all configuration like the labels, epic link, components, then story points, original estimation, time tracking. right? So here is the original estimation. Suppose original estimation is the 8 hours, then we can put over here. Yes, enter 8 hours. So we can write as a 8H. Here is a format already given. If it's a week, then you can write as a 2W, means the 2 week, 4 day, then a 4D. For a day, it's a D. For a hour, it's a H. And for a minute, it's a M. So this is the format that you have to follow. Add original estimation. Hello?
Yes. Go ahead, Smita.
Yes. Okay. Yes. So this original estimation, look at, you can see here, if I'm entering 8 hours, then it will automatically convert into a 1 day, right? Which is our regular timings. Okay, so this story is of the 8 hours, and we have defined its original estimation also. We can define here label name also, means which developers are going to do this. That is done by entering in labels. This is a component. We have to enter in labels. Yes. That is like a sagar. Or if any other person is also there, then we can enter. Okay. So we had to create now a subtask in this story. So here is the option, create subtask. Create subtask. Removing support of Google components. Yes. That. Click on that. Yes. So what is the subtask of this story that we need to enter? Like to remove Google map. Okay. This subtask is created under this story. And this story is linked to this epic, which is a Huawei App Store support. So this is the working flow of this epic module, which we have to deliver in a specified time period, right? So here is your subtask is created, and all the same configuration as we can see in previous stories, that all are here. And you can also mention all the things over here, like labels, original estimation, and components. And you can also add a description here. Need to remove Google map. Like this is from the developer side. If we are doing something business logic or anything descriptive thing that you want to add, then you can add here. You can also add an attachment by uploading a file or any screenshot that you can also write here. This is for a tracking purpose. But mainly we are doing this in a story because it is sufficient for the QA team that this story contains this screen, and this screen have this business logic. So we are adding that in the stories, not in a subtask, because it is difficult to them to go in every subtask and to check that what is the business logic over here and what is the screen design. So it is better. We can put that all things in a story. Right, Rohit?
Correct.
This situation, we have written all these things in a subtask, but we have, at that time, we have decided to put all the things in a Jira story, where in the one story, there is a screenshot. And if any business logic is there, then we can write over there also. So it is feasible for their team also. If this screen have this business logic or this screen have this kind of UI. So you can mention over in the story instead of the subtask.
Basically, it will have a UI. You can attach your screenshot, or you can attach your InVision URL or a Zeppelin URL. It will have a API request response. It will have a validations. It will have a test cases. And also, it will have a business logic. You can also write in and out. Let's say a forgot password. It will come from login. So from where this screen will come in, and from where it will go to the next, right? That we can mark in and out. So I think mentioning this many things would help a developer by seeing a one story, and they will get the whole knowledge. The UI, business logic, in and out, API, validations, test cases. Right? So this we can write it down here. You can also attach your Excel sheets, files, URLs, anything.
Yes, and from development perspective, if you are going to start on any epic, on any story, then you have to first backlog to in progress. And you have to manage these things in your day-to-day life, because if you are thinking that no, I will do it later, then there are the many Jira stories and epics are there, then you will maybe get confused to how to enter your time and what I have done in this. Then it's better to avoid that situation. You have to update your Jira every day, and because if you are updating your Jira every day, then you have a track of your work which you have actually done. So you have to, if you are going to work on this, then you have to change its status from backlog to in progress. Hashik, can you see that? Yes.
Guys, yes. I have one query. Guys, I have, sorry to interrupt you. Okay. But I think at some level, there should be some at the level of task as well, because we can't add all the things in the story, and then that each task should have some information as well, like the scene of the task or the API call of that particular task as well.
Correct. Right. So here we are in a task only. So you are correct. The task we need to split into the subtask. Let's say UI activity, let's say API activity, let's say test cases and validation, which is unit testing. So the task we have to split into the subtask. Correct.
Correct.
But right now we are drafting just an example here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, we have created the different subtasks in this stories for the like API implementation, UI design, business logic, validation. That are the different subtasks we have created over here. But this is just for example.
Whatever the columns I have created over there, these columns are here. So whenever you take it into, you need to mark it as a in progress.
Yes.
Here it is in a backlog right now. But from the backlog right now, I have not started my epic. So let me go to the backlog. From backlog, I can create a sprint now. Right? So now this is UI App Store, which is a 73. Now this is my epic. Epic has a this kind of sign. The purple color with the lightning. Right? Then B is a green color. And the task and a subtask, which has a
blue color.
It is a blue color, right? So, because of time constraint, we have mentioned within only one task only, but you can split the subtask. If I go to the backlog, the things would be available here. Now, for 1 minute, I need to give you the introduction about the versions. Let's say we are working in different versions, like phase 1.0, 2.0, 3.0. Now developers, QA, API developers, designer are working on a phase 1.0, and project lead can start drafting the stories, tasks, subtasks for the phase 2.0. So they can create another version. They can start a communication with client, requirement gathering, the another level. So we can do version by version as well. So let's go to the epic.
Yes. Yeah. We are very short on time. So you have you have to expedite a very fast way, because I don't want this to be a stretch a lot. Yes, Sandeep sir, please go ahead.
Sir, no problem. If it will be stretched for the 15 or 20 minutes because this is the informative sessions and how much detail we share with the developers, it will be helpful for us. So if anyone have any issue, if the session will be stretched to the 15 or 20 minute mode, if no issue, we can continue. No problem, sir.
આ મજા આવશે. અમે 5-1 મિનિટ નું જ રહેવું જોઈએ. હવે વધારે નથી. આપણે જસ્ટ ખાલી સ્પ્રિન્ટ અને ટાઈમ લોક બે જ વસ્તુ કરવાની છે. વી આર ઓન્લી પેન્ડિંગ વિથ ક્રિએટિંગ સ્પ્રિન્ટ એન્ડ ટાઈમ લોક.
જસ્ટ અ મિનિટ, આઈ વોન્ટ ટુ એડ સમથિંગ. શ્વેતા, કેન યુ જસ્ટ શો અપ ધ પીપલ લાઈક હાઉ વી કેન એડિંગ અ એસ્ટિમેટેડ અવર્સ ઇન ધ ટાસ્ક એન્ડ વેન ધ કમ્પ્લીશન ઓફ ધ ટાસ્ક એઝ અ હાફ, પાર્શિયલી ઓર ફૂલ, હાઉ વી કેન એન્ટર ધ વેલ્યુ.
Yes. So can you just show up there? Yes. Harsha sir, can you please go to that subtask? Yes.
Subtask, which is here.
No, this is a epic subtask.
Sorry, this one.
Yes. So how to enter your time log? So you can see here time tracking. Tap on that. Is a note of original estimation we have given. Cancel this and enter 8 hours or 4 hours, whatever in original estimation. Okay, so you have to keep a note for this. If you have a multiple sub task, like as mentioned previously, there is a API task, validation, business logic task. If API task is 2 hours, then business logic and validation is offered 4 hours, let's say that, then total hour is a 6, but also 2 hours is remaining from our previous story. Then also which we have another task that is of the 2 hours. This subtask total is displayed in our story's original estimation time, which is a 8 hour. So if you are giving your original estimation hours as a 8 hour, then it will be whole your story's hour as a 8 hour. And in your subtask, if there is a 2 or 3 subtasks, then these 3 subtasks covers all these hours. Like
Shweta, little bit I just want to correct over here. In the task or subtask, instead of entering the hours in the original, just track that in the time tracking. Enter in the time tracking with the, suppose we have the 2 subtasks or tasks like 4 hours. As yes. A story have a total 8 hours, right? So right. We have a 2 task or a sub task as a 4 hours. So we will enter in the time tracking below.
Okay. So let's say I have a one more task, right? So I can create from here, create, which is task for GrowApp. As the summary, another, I can create another task, the component, again, the iOS. Right, I can mark this Epic UI App Store. So this way,
instead of creating from the outside, you can just directly show from the story itself. So it will be easy for the developer. So they can see.
So let's create one more.
So it will be easy for.
So let's say this story has 8 hours of task. Original estimate. So 4 hours is given to the task number 75. So now I'm going to create one more task. Now this is 76. Now 76, I'm going to split another 4 hours for this task.
Here, Hasya, we will not enter as the original estimation. It is fine. Just directly enter in the time tracking.
Just that time tracking. Yes. Yes, we can do also that because the story is its original estimation hours. Okay. So if you have worked on this task for something like 2 hours, then you can enter your hours log from here. Time tracking. Enter 2 hours from here.
Just in the initial
let's
way.
I took 2 hours, then I can mention time spent here.
Yes,
right? 2 hours. I'm going to mention 2H.
Yes, you can also mention your started date and time also. And if you want to add any comment, then you can also add it from here. Important note for this thing is if any two developers is working on same subtask, then they have to mention their time when they are entering for their time logs over here, then they have to mention their name in this description box. So it will be helpful for our TL.
Can you just enter first, like as a 4 hours as a remaining time, and just save, just remove 2H from the time span as of now. Just add hours as a time remaining, 4 hours.
Here. Four hours.
And just save. So it will be so as like the task which we have created as a subtask has a 4 hours timeline. Now when the developer goes to the task and they are reporting for the task span hours, they just tap on the time tracking and just enter. Like for the task, we have given a 4 hours, but it is completed in the 2 hours. So actual hours will be entered here by the developer. So they enter as a 2 hours. Just enter the 2 hours and save. So it will show as a progress of the task. It can be less or can be exact 4 hours, or maybe in due to any top situations or the logical task, it may increase for the 4 hours. So it will be tracked over here. The task goes bounds of the actual estimation.
Yes.
Okay.
So
this way it would be the time log, right?
Yes.
Now let's go to the backlog and start a sprint. Right?
Yes.
Okay. So now I'm going to the backlog. Now here the backlog is available.
Yes. And we need to create a sprint from here.
Create sprint is available here. So we can create a sprint. Now here you need to drag and drop the number of things which you need to take for the particular sprint to work out, right? So I'm going to take this removing support of Google component, which is a part of the UI App Store support Epic, right? And this has a sprint name. Now I'm going to just a second. I will show you the active sprint column. Now, as you see, nothing is here right now. Developer doesn't have any open backlog to work out. Now, I'm going to start a sprint. This is sprint name, the duration, let's say 1 week. Start date, end date, etc. The sprint goal, another things. Now I'm going to start a sprint. Now I will show you. Yeah, see here that it is available in the to-do. Now this story has this task to complete. So whenever for 76, I think we have given the time, right, Sandeep?
Yes, yes, right.
For 75, we need to give a time.
Yes.
So in the time tracking, I have completed. See, automatically 76, I have added 4 hours. And this whole story has 8 hours. So now automatically it says 4 hours are remaining. Again, I have completed in 4 hours, right? So now total remaining time, 0 minute. Okay, so this way you can add, once you are taking to the development, you have to take it to the in progress. Then once you develop it, now you are doing a unit testing or your project lead is going to review, it will go to the development testing, which is purely a unit testing. Then when you are going to the ready for QC, it will go it here. Okay, just a minute. Now I will show you the another board as well. Here, the QA. Now, whenever I will give it to the QA, this is just for the my understanding, for the lead's understanding. I'm going to bring this task to the ready for QC. So I can see the difference, like what are the backlogs, what are in the development, what are in the review, what are given to the QC. Now, whenever QC will approve, I will keep it in the done, or it could be the ready for client release. Right? And then QA can, whenever it is in, I will ask QA to do the process for this thing, and they can start creating a new bug and etc. So let's say if they are creating a bug. So while creating a bug, they can apply a component UI bug in Google Map remove activity. Let's say this is a bug, right? I'm going to mark a component. Let's say iOS. Whatever the description, the screenshot, screen recording, etc., it would go here. The label, let's say Sagar is working. I will mark a Sagar. Right? Then I can also mark this issue with particular epic as well. Right? And this issue I can mark with a particular story. This story or this task. Let's say this story. So this way, QA will raise a bug and it will be available in the to-do list. This one, 77. Then again, it will go into the development, again ready for QA test, and then it will go to the done. So now I am done for the whole activity. I'm going to complete for the done, and it will go to the client release or a go live or etc. Now I'm going to complete this sprint. Correct? Now it is showing 5 days are remaining. So at the time of complete sprint, sprint cannot be completed in complete subtask. Okay, because the story.
You need to mark 75 and 76 as a complete.
Ready for client release, the last column. This is also for client release. We are also ready for client release. Right? It has a one issue was incomplete. So this is the Kanban board. Now it isn't done. So here you can see the number of issues were done, and there is a one is incomplete. Rohit, can you suggest how to complete this one? I think this is in done column. Rohit?
Hello.
Rohit?
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, sir. Hello.
Now, at the time of closing this sprint, it is saying one issue is incomplete. So, what I need to do? This is saying in a done. But I think this development board is again into in progress. Development ready for QC done, complete sprint.
Yes.
Now again it is saying 74. Just a minute. Okay. Complete the sprint. Incomplete subtask. Rohit?
Yes, Hansia, yes.
Can you help for this 75 and 76? I'm not in a position to complete the sprint. Because
you have to check for the subtask and task first. Under the story, there would be a subtask and task. First, you have to complete those. Then it will be a story will be completed. Then we will be able to close the sprint.
I think this is in a last phase, ready for client release.
Could you please let me know the subtask and task?
This is 75 and 76 are a subtask.
Subtask.
Okay, there is a done. Okay, I got it.
Okay.
Right. Now, the 74 again I need to mark it in a done. Now, I'm going to refresh my page and now I can close my sprint.
That means, Asya, if we want to close our sprint, we must have to first do task and story.
Correct.
Then after we can close our sprint. Right? Correct.
No, I think the task in the previous sprint can be add to the next sprint as well. If you want to close the sprint, current sprint.
Yes, if any backlog is open, any subtask or task or story task is open, you can take it to the another sprint as well.
Sprint as well, yes.
So let's close this sprint and we can get to know the reports.
Asha, very quickly, we are very out of the time.
We are done. We are almost 1 or 2 minute pending.
Time so for this, the is question our,
well. This is the final report for this particular sprint. This is one down chart, one up chart, sprint report, etc. So this way we can do this many activities. So this is all about like types of board. I'm going to revise one more time. So at the time of the development, we have to select Scrum board. At the time of QA process, we have to select a Kanban board. Board columns are very much necessary. Components are very much necessary. Filters are very much necessary, and labels, which are a developer name or a suggestion or a QA or a nothing to do or anything. It could be anything. Labels could be anything which can help you for the filter process. Epic, which is a whole module, whole version, or Epic could have a Epic. Epic will have a story. Story will have a task and subtask. This whole bunch goes to the particular sprint, and there we can manage a time log. And as per the time log, we can get the report. So this is all about the today's topics about Jira. But yes, this many things we are minimum required for our project. This it can be enhanced. We can go in a version by version, but in a very rare projects, which are dedicated projects, right? There it can be applied as a versions, epics, and etc. But yes, in our service industry daily basis project, this is minimum requirement we have to follow. So any questions, any queries from your end?
Yeah, sir, a question from my side, Chaitanya. How we can manage the notification of each task? Suppose if I change the status or change the status of print, anything, where we can configure that one?
So let's say if I'm working right now, as I'm working on a like mobile bug board, right? So I have to be on a board. I have to keep a checking. Close the board. Right. Wait, how to close this report?
Back to project. Click on back to project. Here, from left side.
Okay. Now let's say I'm working on a QA process right now with follow-up of a QA. So here it is, my bug board. I have to close this report.
Back to project. Click on this back to project on left side under Grow App Software Project.
Okay. Okay.
Kanban board pe click kar do.
Okay. Sorry.
Board pe click kar
do. Okay. Understood. Haan. So this is like my column. I have to keep checking here. So whatever issue raised by a QA, that will keep coming here in the to-do list. And as per that, I have to take a task in the development, mentioning into the in progress, then ready for QA, and then done. If any task come from the end side for the development, will come into the to-do list.
Actually, his question was how to get the notification.
I have to get the notification.
Could you please open any issues from the Kanban board? Yeah.
Okay.
There is a share icon top right corner. Before that, there is a eye icon.
Okay.
You have to click on this for watching, continuous watching. And this is a Nile account. So Nile will get only the notification. No another member of the another team member will get the notification. If you want to get the notification, then you should have the your individual account. Then only you will be able to get the notification. And you have to watch each and every, click on the eye icon to watch each and every bug or any epic or task for the progress. So you will get the notification for each and every activity being done in this board. And one more thing, you will track. You will able to track from here, from the history. Hasya, there yes. will be a history. Please scroll down. There will be a history tab.
Okay. If I want to add someone to watch this issue, I can add it here.
Yeah.
So they will get continuous notification over email and etc.
Yes, but they should have a different accounts.
Yes, they should have Jira account.
Please scroll down.
Okay.
Yes.
Scroll down below the attachment, environment attachment. There is a work log. There is a history tab. You can track everything from here. What are the activities being done in this particular task or bug or whatever the things we are going in particular individual task. So as for now, that we are not having a much account. So we are mentioning the labels over there. That's why we are mentioning the labels of the in terms of adding a developer's name. We have limitations of the accounts. That's why.
Okay. It means suppose I am working in one five members is working in one project, and yes. So I am directly add all the five members in my project, right? In a watcher. And all the
No, you cannot add all the five members should have a different account first of all, then yeah, only yeah. you can able to add in the vouchers.
Okay, but if all the five this is also the same facility available in a project, right?
Yes,
a project view. Okay.
Yeah. And anybody want to if you are taking this project forward, if you suppose you are a project lead and you are taking this project forward, and if you want to add in a watchers list, then it will be fine that you can also add in the watch list. But as an individual, I am also interested to know the progress of each and every bug. Then I can also log in into my account and I can go to any of the task or bug and I can click on the eye icon to watch that particular task or bug.
Okay.
Okay, then.
Sorry.
Okay, like.
Go ahead, Hasir.
So Mohaji sir, some credit to Rohit as well. In the like previous weeks, learned too many things about the Jira from Rohit only, and he helped us for that configuration, example, and etc.
Sure.
A few things I learned 6 months back in another project. Few another things I learned just within this month.
Sure. Thank you so much, Rohit.
You're welcome.
Creamy, any questions from your end? Creamy, can you hear us? Okay, I guess Creamy is not longer with us. Okay, we have a Pearl. Pearl, do you have any questions? Pearl, you need to unmute yourself if you want to ask any questions. Okay, I guess she's also not with us. Okay, we have a new guy, Sagar Booth. Can you, like, do you have any questions so far?
No, not yet.
Okay, sounds good. So, I guess nobody has a question so far. So,
Rishi, I have one question. Hi, Shashank here. Good morning. Good morning to all of you. Like, I have one question for all the development, like development lead and development team. Like, I was just watching this sprint planning and how you are writing stories and all the things. I would like to know, like, you know, when we are writing n number of stories for particular product or particular application, and at the time of sprint planning, don't you consider about story points or like whom to assign this particular story? Because like when we're talking about sprint planning, so I'm just saying, like, you know, you are just randomly picking stories, but there are some story points. Like for every story, there could be some weightage. So do we consider these things also at the time of sprint planning or not?
Weightage in terms of?
See, every, like, if you can go for every story, like just go to a story, like you can go to our backlog. Please go to the backlog.
Mm-hmm.
Please click on any story.
Okay. Assume this is the backlog right now for me.
Yes. Yeah, so please click on any story.
Okay. Then?
Show 5 more fields.
Okay.
No, yes, this is not filled. Like, please move to backlog. Like, please go to backlog, actual backlogs, or actual product backlog. Yeah.
Yeah. So in a way, what Shashank is trying to say is, whenever we add any kind of a stories, task, or anything, they do have a story points.
Yes.
Into that. So are we taking care of that story points in that? Because one of the basic thing into Agile, so everything they don't consider into hours of efforts. There is a way of, let's say, making out story points as well. So Rizwan sir, if you can highlight some your points into this, how we can use story points.
Yes, we have to define a point to each of the story. Like we can define a 2 point, 8 point, 10 point, yes. 20. There are a few numbers. There is some odd numbers to assign to each of the stories.
And what is a factor that we use to us? What this point means basically?
Upon us. A point means the task length. Let me give a simple example. Mm-hmm. If we have the simple login screen, that can take maximum 8 hours. And if we give the point point two or three to that story. Now we have the longer task of about 80 hours. We can say. That story point will have 40 points. Like same way we can define each of story to have different points, and based on those points, we have to select the sprint. In 2 weeks sprint, how much point we can cover in this sprint?
Correct. So it is basically it is like criticality.
So as per the criticality,
you have to define the make sure that each of the those tasks is defined. There should not be a like R&D or something like task into the story, because we have to define certain limit of each task. And based on that limit of the task, we can add that task into sprint. And by doing this, we can do the reporting of the sprint, and we can measure what is the speed of our team to work on. Yes. Like say, they can finish about 2, 2, 2, 2, or like 2 point, 10 point, 15 point, or for the 40 point in a week. So that way we can define the speed of each sprint of our development team as well. And based on our speed and pace, we have to define the next sprint. So if any of the task is remaining, and
yes, so that
point should be removed. Like we have a large task of 40 points.
Yes.
Yes, that will be a pure Scrum thing. We have to define each of the story as a point, and that point should be defined with the sprint as well.
Yes.
Yes.
So adding to this, like, you know, like when we are saying like there are 15 stories in one backlog.
Yeah.
And if I'm adding, like, initially I don't have any idea about my team capacity for this particular project development.
Yeah, okay.
And if I'm randomly picking 5 stories which are having weightage like story point of 60, and sprint duration is 2 weeks, and after completion of sprint, if I'm able to complete a task of story point 40,
so
it will help me to plan another sprint.
Like another sprint. That's
my idea. I will get idea like my team is capable to complete 40 points
only. Yeah.
So based on that, I can plan next sprint. And like based on our experience, like whatever capacity of my team. So based on that, I can easily all about story points, and story point also give you idea about, like, you know, how like priority, like this is
of a task. I think this the estimation will be based on the complexity of the task.
Yes.
If the task is too much complex, then the point will be higher. And if the task is simple, then the point then the point will be lower, right?
Yes. So I guess we need to consider the story points things also at the time of planning.
Yes, we have to. But to do that, we have to apply Scrum purely. Like to not to move developer, not to change the task, not to change anything into the task and everything. But,
yes, so that is what our next level, right? So if we have a dedicated project, in that we can do like in that configuration.
We should not move the developer from the any sprint or the team. We have to define a particular team for each project, and that team should continue to work to do that's the entire project probably.
Correct. So as we are in a service industry, so this many configuration is required. But if we have a dedicated project where sprint is going, versions, epics are going, there we need to do that story point, weightage, and etc. configuration. So we can do one thing. We can have the chapter-wise chapter. So in today's chapter, we can cover this many things. Mm-hmm. Now for the another configuration, story point, story weightage, that we can do in the next session. So slowly, everyone can digest.
Yes.
Okay.
Right, Mercy sir?
Yeah, definitely, yes.
Mercy sir is very out of time, mate.
I know. Because see, everybody is coming by taking a time on Saturday. I don't want to provide any kind of a false things.
Okay, sir.
Good. Strict on a 1 hour. We need to honor the timing that everybody is putting on a Saturday.
Okay.
Yes.
Any other question?
Any other questions anybody have? Okay. This recording will also be available in one of the YouTube channels. We'll be sharing the recording soon. Thank you so much, Hasya sir, for providing such an insightful. Very big thank you for Sweta, because wish you a very happy birthday. I know it's hard day like to make out the sessions. Thank you so much for taking the time and making the sessions on your birthday, and we wish that next all the years you will be giving such kind of insightful sessions to us.
Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, guys.
It would be her memorable day that she had given one demonstration on her birthday.
Yeah. True. Okay. Guys, do we have any suggestion for the next Saturday? Anybody has any kind of a recommendations what we should cover?
Maharshi Shashank here, like if team can continue with these Jira activities, so it will be also helpful for everyone.
Okay, so one is the Jira next sessions. Okay. Any other recommendations?
One session should be on communication, like how we communicate and how we can communicate effectively.
Okay, so one is about the communication skills, how we can do it a better way. So there is a two words, Rahul last time also mentioned the same. Yes, guys, anything else? Any recommendations, any suggestions, anything that you think of? It can be a project management, it could be a specific technology, it could be tools, it could be any project understanding. Okay, fine. So we'll try to come up with something new, something good into next Saturday sessions as well. And in meantime, if you have any kind of a recommendation, please share with us. We are open. That's all, guys. Thank you so much for joining. Really appreciate your timings. Yeah, sorry. Just a final note on overall business operations. So this is specifically for the Ahmedabad location people. So we know that, okay, the things has been started out. Offices started working out. Restrictions of 8 to 4 and the curfew after 7 and etc. So our office at Ellis Bridge, so it has been sanitized. It has been all the clean and everything has been done. So it is now work in the workable conditions. If anybody has any kind of issues, any kind of, let's say they wanted to work from office, they cannot do, they have internet issues, device requirements, anything, they can go to the office and they can do it. Right now, we are not doing any kind of office works as of now. As of now, everybody is working remotely because we need to take care about health and safety of all our peoples out there, all our Brainers family. So that's what we are taking care as important steps. And we'll keep you posted well in advance whenever we are starting any kind of a backup operations back in back. But still, if you anybody has wanted to go to office, anybody wants to have any work, it is open 24/7. Whenever you want to go, you can do that. Done, guys. Sure. Thank you so much. Have a great weekend ahead.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Yes.
Thank you all.
Bye bye.
Thank you.